الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Welcome to the second part of our episode tonight at the North Brixton Islamic Cultural Center. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from all of us. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cure the sick and those who are going through chronic illnesses, Ya Kareem. Those Muslim around, wherever they are, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease their burden. May Allah make all of us live, die, and be with the day of judgment as pious Muslims. My dear brothers and sisters, we are looking at Surah Al-Ra'd, where the Sheikh asked me to talk about, or to recite the ayat, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about the qualities of the Ulul Albab, the qualities of the people of understanding. And we mentioned that, just a summary, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in verse 19, where he said that the one who knows the truth and testify and believe that the Quran or the message revealed to the Prophet ﷺ is truth, are they equal with the one, or are they the same with the one who does not have, with the one who is blind? Allah said, actually or verily, those who take heed are the people of understanding. And he mentioned in another ayah, he said the quality of the people of understanding are the people who fulfill their promise, or the oath or covenant they took with Allah, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he mentioned amongst the qualities of those people, the ulul albab, are those who connect the family ties and bonds. They do not break family ties because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants them to connect that tie. And he said at the same time, they fear Allah and they fear the day of reckoning. They're going to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah said, those are the people who patiently persevere and they do things to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They establish salah, irregardless of their situations. And then they spend from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided them openly and secretly, just to please Allah. And they repel evil with good. They don't pay evil with evil, but rather they pay evil with good. Allah said, those are the people who have eternal garden, eternal home. May Allah make us be amongst them. And Allah described the eternal home. He said that underneath the Al-Jannah you have jannat, streams, garden. Underneath you have flowing of streams, running. And Allah said, also as well, they will join them, or they will be joined by their fathers, those who are pious. They establish a salah and obey Allah in this world. And likewise their spouses, likewise their children, their offsprings. Allah said, when they enter, the angels will come to them from all angles, from all doors, welcoming them, saying to them, yeah, the Sheikh said on condition, that's why I mentioned that, the pious ones amongst them, the one who does good, the one who obey Allah, those are the ones who will join them. And for their family who do not obey Allah, then here's the disaster. May Allah save us from that category. But the angels will come unto them from all angles, from all doors. They will say to them this beautiful statement, Salamun alaykum bima sabartum. May the peace and blessing of Allah be upon you for the patience that you patient when you were in this dunya. What a beautiful, what an excellent, excellent final place of abode. And then Allah talked about the opposites. For those who do not take heed, the people of those heedlessness, Allah said they are the ones who break family ties. Or first of all, they break the covenant they had with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They do not worship Allah because every child is born as Muslim or with inclined to the faith, the iman, believe in Allah. So when they come, you've taken that oath at the time of Adam, as the Sheikh was saying in the previous lectures. So therefore, when they break that tie or that covenant, the oath, and also as well, they break the ties of the family, and these people are the ones who spread mischief in the land. He said, those ones, Allah's curse is upon them. And Allah said, وَلَهُمْ سُوءُ الدَّارِ. They have terrible home. They're going to be be admitted or enter. May Allah save us from that. And the beautiful verse we ended before, we stopped at before Salah. Allah said, اللَّهُ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who stretches or gives his provision to whomever he will and in restraint. He has decreed everything. Allah said, وَفَرِحُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. But people rejoice for the vanities of this world and these worldly things. Allah said, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ. These worldly things that we're running after, the whole world that we're running after compared to the hereafter, Allah said, إِلَّا مَتَاعٌ. Is nothing but vanity, something that will fade here and there, but it will never last for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us. My dear brothers and sisters, in summary, this is what we've learned just before Salah, and I'll pass the mic now to our able dear Sheikh, Sheikh Dr. Faisal Buhari, to take us from there. Fadatufadar Sheikh Mashkur.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah, you are still alive. Alhamdulillah, finish praying. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah bless all of us. These qualities are very important qualities. And mashallah, especially in the month of Ramadan, as we're approaching, you should try to inculcate these kind of qualities and so forth, so that in the month of Ramadan, we really establish it. And after the month of Ramadan, we put it more into practice. And subhanAllah, when you are looking at it, especially in Ayah 23, you know, when you look at Ayah 23, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about the family Jannah, where we join them together. SubhanAllah. Those who were good, you see, this is why it's so important. The members of your family, members of your family should try as much as possible to make each one of them practice the deen, so that you will not be separated. You will not be separated. But instead of being in Jannah, the same Jannah, Allah will not separate you. You will be in the same thing. And hence, the dua of Hamlatul Arsh, the dua of the carriers of the throne of Allah. I love this dua all the time. Even the angels who are holding the arsh, the throne of Allah, are praying for us to get that family Jannah. SubhanAllah. They are praying for us. And you are not concerned regarding this one. You don't care what your family members are doing. Whether you are practicing or whether you are not practicing, I don't care what. As long as I am practicing, that is enough. Let's go to Quran chapter 40, Surah Ghafir, ayah 7 to 9. And everybody should try to memorize this kind of a dua before the month of Ramadan. And inshallah, you will be able to do it. Say inshallah.
Inshallah.
Inshallah, you do it, or inshallah, you're not going to do it.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. It's a covenant you have made. It's the same covenant you are talking about here, you know? You have made that covenant now.
From verse 7. It's chapter 40, Surah Ghafir. Surah Ghafir. Chapter 40. We're going to start from verse 7 to 9. Inshallah. But this one I want you to repeat after me. You need to learn it. Inshallah, very important. Chapter 40. Surah Ghafir. Have you seen it? This is the dua, the supplication of the carrier of the throne of Allah, the angels that carry the throne of Allah, their dua. Amazing, subhanAllah. Look at the dua, the supplication they make for you. May Allah grant us al-Jannah. All those who are sick all over the world, may Allah cure them.
Ameen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our end be the best, Ya Kareem. Have you seen it? Are we ready? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم
الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم بسم الله ان شاء الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم الله سبحانه وتعالى says الذين يحملون العرش the angels that carry the throne of Allah سبحانه وتعالى ومن حوله and those around it not only them and those around it Allah said يسبحون بحمد ربهم they send glory to their Lord Allah سبحانه وتعالى glorifying him
وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. They believe in him, that he is their creator, he is their cherisher, and the one that originated them from nothing, and they became who they are. Allah said, وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Those angels who carry the throne and those around them, they seek forgiveness every day for those who believe. As long as you believe in Allah and you believe in the angels, you believe in the messenger and you believe, you have of course in the angels and the books, etc. Allah sees those angels, they seek forgiveness for you. That's their job. Because their job, Allahu Akbar. Allah said they see. Rabbana, these are the angels saying this supplication. You get it, yeah? The angels, they say, Rabbana, O our Lord, O Allah, wasi'ta kulla shay'in rahma. Allah, implore forgiveness. Yeah? Sorry. Your mercy, your forgiveness, your mercy encompass everything. Your mercy encompass everything, unlimited. Wa'ilmi. And your knowledge as well. فَغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا. Oh Allah, forgive those who turn to you in repentance. Anyone who say, oh Allah, please forgive me. Allah forgive that person. وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ. And those who follow your path, forgive them, Allah. Not only that, please Allah, waqihim adhab al-jahim. The angels say, oh Allah, protect them from the punishment and chastisement of Jahannam Jahim. Please Allah, protect them. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
And they say, Rabbana, oh Allah. Wa adkhiluhum. Allah, please admit them. Adkhiluhum, admit them. Jannati adn. In Jannah adn. The paradise garden of eternity. Please Allah, admit them in that Jannah. Allati wa'adtahum. The paradise that you've promised them. Please Allah, give it to them. But not only them. وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ آبَائِهِمْ. And the righteous ones of their fathers. Amongst their fathers, the righteous ones. Please Allah, admit them as well in al-Jannah. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
And not only their fathers or parents. Wa azwajihim, and their spouses, their mothers, their wives. Allah, please admit them, their spouses.
What the husband and wife. That's the husband and wife, huh? Allahu Akbar.
Yeah? And their spouses. Wa dhurriyatihim. But not only them also, and their offsprings, their children. The pious ones amongst their children. Please Allah, admit them in al-Jannah. Innak. Indeed, you Allah, antal aziz. You are the most exalted one in might. Al-Hakim, the most wise. And they will say, oh Allah, waqihim as-sayyi'at. Please Allah, protect them from all evil, from all error, from all disaster, from all ills. وَمَنْ تَقِلَ السَّيِّئَاتِ يَوْمَئِذٍ فَقَدْ رَحِمْتَ. For verily, whosoever or whoever you protect from your punishment, from your chastisement, from that sayyi'at, that person, Allah, you have indeed bestowed your mercy upon him or her. May Allah make us be amongst them.
Amen.
And they said, when we do trade, one gets money, one gets everything. They said, I won, I am successful. Allah said, that's not success. He said, for you to be protected from Allah's punishment, the day of judgment, and then enter al-Jannah with your family and your spouses, Allah said, وَذَلِكَ. And that is what we called, هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. It is the greatest achievement ever one could achieve. May Allah make us be amongst them.
Amen. SubhanAllah. You know, it is so amazing that you have the heavenly creations who are so busy asking forgiveness for us. And we do not care. And we do not care. And these creatures, they are so busy asking forgiveness for us. Not once in a year, no. All the time, that's it. When they are holding that, that's all their supplications for us. We have to be very, very, that's why we have to make a lot of supplications, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. Because Prophet said, I used to seek forgiveness from Allah each day. How many times? How many times? 100 times. And he had been forgiven. His sins had been forgiven. What about me and you? You know. So there's something we have to seek forgiveness for all the time. It reminds me of the dream that I had about 2 or 3 days ago. And in that dream, subhanAllah, I was holding something like a rope or whatever. And I was saying this kind of word to her. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la wa bihamdihi, Allahumma gfirli. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la wa bihamdihi, Allahumma gfirli. I was saying this kind of several times. And then the voice was telling me to tie this kalma, this statement, with the rope that I have. So I said, this kalma is so big. Therefore, this rope cannot tie. And it was still telling me. So when I tried to do it, I saw a very long tunnel, big one, and we do not know where the end comes from. And there were so many beautiful things coming. You know, it's coming round like that, from inside, different colors. And I kept on saying, Subhana Rabbi Allah bihamdi Allah makfir, until like my soul was coming out from me, Subhanallah. And then I was crying in the dream. And I kept on saying these things until my alarm just went off for Salat Tahajjud.
MashaAllah.
And even in the Tahajjud, when I was praying, when I went to the Sajda, I could not stop saying these things. SubhanAllah, I kept on saying all the time. Okay. What does that mean? Who can tell me the meaning of that?
You know, I believe all of you, probably, the time you get your dreams, you go to Sheikh Google. You become dream interpreters. So this is the right time for you to interpret dreams. All the Sheikh Google dreams that you've interpreted, so it's time now for you to interpret this one. What does that mean? Based on the little bit of understanding Allah gave us. Subhana Rabbil A'la wa bihamdi. Allahumma ghfirli. What does it mean? Leave the dream. What does that kalima mean? What does it mean?
My own place belongs to him.
Oh, God, forgive me.
Mashallah. Now, our humble brother said, pray glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all praises be unto him. And they say, oh Allah, forgive me. Right? Mashallah. Okay. Now, inshallah, the time is due. We'll give opportunity to ask questions, and our sheikh is here to answer.